Hello everyone. Thank you all very much. Very much for coming today. Sorry, this is my cheat sheet. Now I talk about findings in preparation of upgrading to my MySQL. My name is David Zodnat. I belong to the Information Technology Division of Square Enix. I hope to enjoy my presentation. And I prepared this language version of the presentation. This presentation was translated by Ivan Tu. Yeah. Thank you. And also, Radio. And also, Radio, this presentation by Chen. He is a young, our colleague, and also engineer of our division in Square Enix. And also, he comes from Taiwan. Yeah. He is a very skillful, sophisticated engineer. So thank a lot of Ivan and Chen for translating and reading. This presentation consists one introduction of our group, two, our usage of MySQL, three, our trying to upgrade to MySQL 8. For our next plan, finally, our request to all of the corporation. And if you have any suggestion for this presentation and our program, talks later, don't hesitate to suggest. So any suggestion will welcome today. On the screen. So, let me introduce our group. So, we are a social game infrastructure group. Our role runs contract operating server systems for browser game here. And arcade game right there, and the mobile games of each product.
Yeah, this one is our
lot of games we operate. And we operate ES server, including database instances. That amount is over 7,000 instances in cloud, AWS, and GCP. So infra is one of Japanese domestic cloud services. Their homepage is this. And now I'm going to show a short movie of our product. That name is Final Fantasy Medius. This product is also operated by us. And this server system is also running MySQL. This product is available in Apple Store or Google Play of Taiwan. Now let's play a movie. And sorry, ask for all of you, during showing this movie, please stop, take picture, sorry, of this movie, and stop recording video of the movie. Quality of 3D computer graphics rendered in real time in your smartphone. Yes. If you have interest in this game, we will be glad to if you play this game. So I will talk about our usage of MySQL. Database instance we operate include MySQL and PostgreSQL. Video is okay? Okay. database instance we operated into my recently, we also operate other database like Mongo, but nowadays we don't use it. It just calls to end of one of our product which uses Mongo. Simply ended the services. So, as you can see at the graph, yeah, this graph, we are mainly running MySQL. And about the MySQL licenses, our major usage is committing edition. And the same systems use standard edition or enterprise edition, both from Oracle Corporation. Approximately, we bought over 60 licenses from Oracle Corporation. Oh, sorry, hurry. Thank you, Oracle.
It's okay.
All systems have many MySQL edge units. Normally, MySQL consists of one master and thread. This is a basic unit. Normally, MySQL unit consists of, n is least two. So, one thread until over two threads we use. Thread servers consists of one thread for backup. Yeah, this one. And the other four game systems. Mainly from viewpoint of load runs, basically we script MySQL unit. Some is master data. So this is a fundamental data of gaming. Yeah, this one. And it's like the strength of the data of each enemies, and has the health point of each armor, and so on. Some is for player data, which is the state of each player, like what armor they have. Player is under protect or bubble or at this moment. How many score value each player have. Some units store session cache. It will normally use a quickly distinct network connection to players. Some units store log. They store system event log, sometimes debug log, and player's behavior history for customer support usage. And also, some tables split horizontally over several MySQL units for load balancing. Normally, player data and session cache are placed horizontally split tables. Let's talk about our challenge. Our challenge is upgrading to MySQL 5.6 to MySQL 8. Why we should upgrade 5.6 to 8? The one reason is 5.6 will reach end of life 2025 February. Other reason is that developers of game system want to use new feature of MySQL 8. Some of our new system build are already built using MySQL 8. So we decided first we try to upgrade from MySQL 5.6 to MySQL 8. If we have issues upgrading, then we would upgrade to MySQL 5.7 and next step upgrade 5.7 to 8. However, we tried but we reach this conclusion. Under our business requirements, discover later, we did on directly upgrade from MySQL 5.6 to MySQL 8. And now, let's talk about some pitfalls about the upgrading to MySQL 8. So, because our business requirements are first, main dash window not available at the same time, which means not available after, is less than 12 hours. Less than 12 hours. If main dash window is longer than these hours, customer will seem to disappoint in our service. Oh, hey, yeah, and how long is this, longest of this main dash window, so on. Second, small workloads do no impact to our developers. Example for avoiding heavy amount of application by developers for upgrade, or avoiding a large amount of logic modification. If our team failed to reduce developers' impact, developers tend to feel negative to upgrade to MySQL 8. Then we can't handle quality. Some keep higher availability level of MySQL after upgrading. First, we need to check if this point satisfies the above limitations. Comparing MySQL configuration parameter is okay. Second, compare MySQL configuration parameter is okay for our needs. Devices format of in the daily is okay. Impact on tools. Impact on tools. We usually use is okay. Yeah, get to get up to here, all okay. But however, high availability options we can use is not good. Upgrading method we can take is not good. This is why we give up upgrading to directly MySQL 8. Let's compare MySQL configuration parameters. MySQL 5.6 versus MySQL 8. So we concern in this page, the difference that we are concerned about shown in red. Yeah, red letter. But yeah, our concern. As you can see, changing capital set UTF to UTF MV4. Here. Here are the column default correlation for UTF-8MV4. Default value is UTF-8MV4 0900AICI. In the daily script mode changes off and on. And optimize the switch and new values, escape secret mode, and add more some new values here. About one comparing my secret configuration parameter is okay. That reason are one reason, also reason. Migration from UTF-8 to UTF-8MV4 is almost okay. There are small possibilities we should explain the length of prompts. The UTF-8MV4 strings need more bytes than UTF-8, but this is subtle difference for our needs. Second reason, the demo correlation should change from UTF-MV4 0900AICI to UTF-8MV4-0900ASTS. And UTF-8MV4-0900AICI, SQL doesn't care about the difference of punctuation of Japanese. However, UTF-8MV4-0900ASTS does. Optimizer switch is okay, but SQL 8 default. There aren't a major problem in our needs. Number 4, SQL model is okay. MySQL 8 default setting is more strict, but it too strict for our needs in testing. We can do less strict settings. Yeah, it is fast. About two devices, 541 of InnoDB is okay. In previous MySQL 8, InnoDB 541 was Anthrop. In MySQL 8, InnoDB 5 format changed to Barracuda. And there are no option other than it. Fortunately, we don't use Antelope specific tools, so we have no problem with format change. If you want to use some tool which directly analyze InnoDB 5, you should check them available in Barracuda. Impact on tools we usually use in OK. We tested tools we usually use in testing environment under MySQL 8 with test data. We confirmed there were no big problems for 1 year without modification of our tools. Yeah, it is also lucky. However, as you already know, we are just lucky. Around this topic. Generally speaking, enough tests are always needed. It is good. If we would find some malfunctions which come from difference between the versions of MySQL, there is possibility of massive modification to our tools. Our high-availability options we can use is not good for our needs. In MySQL 5.6, we use MHA. All of you, so do have you known the MHA? Raise your hand. Thank you. MHA is a major middleware in Japan. In MySQL 5.6, we use MHA as our important system. MHA is abbreviated MySQL High Availability. MHA is simple and easy to use to provide strong port plans to MySQL master slave unit. And MHA, if master database happens to start by some failure, like a server failure or network unstable, MHA will automatically change MySQL slave to master. Under MHA, MySQL unit continue its service. even you create a master database. However, in MySQL, MHA development seems to stop. Seems to stop 2012. And also we latest release work up to MySQL 5.6. We haven't confirmed my MHA correctly was under MySQL 8. AWS, but we are not so much heavy use AWS. If you use AWS, use RDS or MySQL 8 instance. If not, do use in the DB cluster the previous sessions, previous sessions. So seem to provide high availability feature. Unfortunately, we only have few systems using AWS. If we were to migrate to AWS, we are consuming more time and money than simply upgrade MySQL. Regarding in the DB cluster, we haven't had enough experience to use it until now. We need further study for this. Upgrading method we can take is not okay under our business requirements. One of our requirements, maintenance window less than 12 hours. Amount of volume of MySQL units are still growing, growing and growing every day. Normally they reach more than a few terabytes one instance. We have been looking for methods for with shorter time requirements for upgrading to our MySQL 8, but haven't found any at this moment. We think about utilize replication between MySQL 5.6 and as master here to MySQL 8 thread here. In advance, we would have synced our master to thread by start of maintenance. We could just only change MySQL 8 to master in maintenance. So this is our idea of imagination, not use. Please. We could just only change MySQL here. MySQL master and in maintenance and spoiled MySQL 5.6. This would make maintenance time either shorter. In our company, this strategy is popular. This method is simple. Yeah, very simple. And easy to understand. And easy to use. We think the strongest merit of this method is that we can handle previous problems without service impact to our customers. However, directly replication between MySQL 5.6 and MySQL 8 is not supported. First we check this, we know this, we are so amazing. This is one kind of like, or worse, and worse. Placing MySQL 5.7 as thread in the middle of replication chain is also not supported here. So we simply insert this. So 5.7 and 8, okay? And 5.67 is okay? Oh, totally okay with first thing. However, as the reference manual, placing three buttons in replication at the time, this is not supported. Oh. We still need further study why lackness of ability of replication with three buttons. So we need to take a two-step upgrade method. First, to prepare for maintenance, we put MySQL for 5.7 and sync between MySQL 5.6 and 5.7. Second step, in maintenance, we change MySQL 5.7. To master change settings of cluster set and enable GKID. And upgrade to MySQL itself with override and run MySQL upgrade command. However, we haven't estimated this step within 12 hours. With a large amount of MySQL volume, even terabytes. We need further study. We are currently planning to evaluation in the cluster of MySQL 8. Check how long it will take to run. MySQL upgrade command with large amount of MySQL volumes. Sorry. We expect to order compilation to. Send the patches to this. They are very, very well known for me, but we don't have any engineering at the ability have modified MySQL itself. So expect Oracle Corporation to please support the replication not only between next generation of MySQL. But also between generation beyond that. With these change, we found out that with large MySQL volume replication between more generations of MySQL is necessary. This feature makes easy estimation of maintenance time we should take. That's all of our presentation. Thank you for hearing of my presentation. So any questions?
有没有问题？我想真的可能在一个实战的upgrade里面，但这个对于我们来说的Oracle来说，这个是很大的一个挑战。我会继续跟我们的台湾公司一起把这个历史带来。
some presentation is wrong currently.
They asked, there are something wrong with not you, but my translation. We can add some typos.
Yeah,
I'm sure they will.
Thank you. So, any suggestion or questions? So I think one of the smart people, I do. Yeah. Really, not hesitate.
Okay.
所以如果没有问题的话，那我们就感谢曼山的分享，谢谢。那下午我们这个 track 呢是1:10开始下午。